Hi Pisces, guys. This is the second reading that I'm uploading. Actually, the first one that I posted for the November reading, I have taken it down, and I'm posting this instead. So this is going to be for Pisces Sun Moon Rising. The reason that I have taken down the previous reading is because I think I was very emotional in that, and I don't want this to be a channel about myself, but. At the same time, it's not like I didn't want to share it, or I did it like I regret doing it. I don't. It's just that I feel that I'm not ready yet to share my experiences, my personal life as yet. And also, the day I recorded that video was actually the moon was in Pisces that day, and I'm a Piscean, of course, as you guys are. And I'm heavily influenced by Pisces, so that day I was actually very emotional, so I wasn't ready actually to speak that much about myself, but I did. And and actually before I was uploading, I had it in my mind that I'll keep it for at least one day and then I'll take it down. So yeah, this is your second reading. And guys, those of you who replied to me on that video, thank you so much for your support, guys. I really, really appreciate it, and I truly value your presence in my life, especially someone named Paddy K. If you're watching this video, I'm truly grateful to you as well. I think I haven't been able to reply to your previous comment that you made, so kindly excuse me for that. And let's see what's coming in for Pisces now. People tell me that Ayushi, do not worry about the fact that you live near a railway line. So because I often used to complain that my videos get interrupted because of the train, so I got a lot of comments, and I actually do get it, like every time I complain about train passing by and disturbing my readings. And I apologize, like I feel really guilty because I really want these videos to be like, I can't soundproof, of course, right now. I don't have even a really good camera or a noise cancelling equipment or stuff like that. But people often tell me, like, you know, I should do not worry about the train passing by because it's nice and this and that. And I actually do not mind, but if someone is like a subscriber of mine is actually listening to my video on earphone, then they will obviously not gonna like it. So that's one reason that the area that I am putting up in bothers me a little bit. And enough with that, guys. Excuse me for that train, basically that's what I'm trying to say. I can't help it. Anyway, so you have Magician here coming out, which is having some. You basically need a lot of, you don't need, but what do you have? What do you have? You need to ask yourself, what do I have in terms of ideas, in terms of money, in terms of emotions, in terms of action? So do I make enough efforts when it comes to physical action? Do I do things the way, the thoughts that I think about, do I implement them? You have to ask this yourself. And how much emotionally balanced am I, and how much emotional involvement do I have in the work that I am doing? Then you will have to ask yourself, do I have enough money on me? Am I putting this money that I have in the right place, so that I can benefit from the investment that I am making? You have an idea, so you should be asking yourself, how do I bring this idea into physical reality? How do I bring people to see what I have thought about? how can I implement it and how can I be successful doing that. So that's what I'm getting from this card. Now what I'm also getting here is that you feel like Eight of Swords, which is not feeling like you can move, feeling like you are stuck, feeling like you don't have an option, feeling like somebody trapped you, feeling like a situation is not leaving you and it's strangling you basically. So how do you move from this space to this space? Well, this is coming for you, like it's coming for you, and this is where you are currently. So in order to make use of this energy, first you have to accept the fact that you do have blessings coming in your way. If you believe that nothing is happening for you, nothing good is happening, then that's what you are going to receive, because you are not going to realize the opportunities that you are going to get. So unless you accept the fact that blessings are indeed coming for you, you won't be ready to receive. So be ready to receive and open your mind and open your eyes to what is coming your way. Start recognizing it and then start putting all those things that are coming your way in a manner that it helps you build something, not in a way that that something comes your way and then you put it aside because you want to not think about it, or you are not feeling emotionally well, or you want to just postpone it. Don't do that. Look at it and understand how much of a blessing this is, this resource. This resource is a blessing for you and it has come only for you. So if you are not going to respect it, then it's gonna go to waste. And then again, you will be here, stuck. So let's see what's coming up for Pisces Sun, Moon, Rising. You can also be dealing with the Aries person who has kept you in a very stuck place. They don't like, you don't know what to do with them. And if it's not an Aries person, then you are dealing with somebody who is like a trickster, like a very smooth person who talks smoothly and they have all the right answers and they chit chat and they talk all the right stuff, and then they mislead you basically. That's the energy. So yeah, this reading is for Pisces Sun, Moon and Rising. For November 2018, 10 card Celtic Cross. Okay. Feeling betrayed, feeling separated, feeling as if karma is not in your favor, feeling let down, feeling like you have to finally understand the fact that something has left you and they are not coming back, and they have it's not a person. What I'm talking about here is an experience has caused you a lot of pain and now it's over. So accept that the situation is over. It's painful right now, but justice has been restored. Now I'm not saying that you did a wrong thing, so you got betrayed. I'm just getting that it's a very nice opportunity for you to balance it now. Like whatever experience that you gathered through this experience, whatever that you gathered, whatever the lessons that you gathered through this experience, it will come handy when you meet the similar situation next time, and you are a wiser person now. So your decisions will be much better in future. You can rely on yourself when you are making decisions, because you have had faced certain situation in your life which was very tough to handle, but you did it. So now the second train is passing by. Some of you are getting a divorce and it's final ending. This is a family card. This is the betrayal. I'm also getting that someone is done betraying. Like there is no chance for someone to come back again. It's finally over. is the message that I'm getting. You can be dealing with a Libra. Well, it's time to move on definitely. This is the card talking about how you are done and you are heading towards the rainbow. If you were in your mind about leaving a situation, this is the time that you are leaving. You're finally deciding, I am done. I cannot stay in this darkness anymore. And the question that you are asking is, where do I go from here? Which path do I take? I have seen so much, but still I don't know where to head from here. So that's the question that I'm getting. Let's see what messages we have for Pisces Sun Moon Rising. Sun of Pentacles, Heart of the Matter, Fool is crossing you. Your root energy is Four of Wands. Your past is Justice. Your hopes and desires is Ace of Swords. Ambition, Ace of Swords. In future, you have Ten of Pentacles. You come up as Sun of Swords. So you are studying about something, or you are dealing with kids. But you are studying as well about something new. And then your surrounding energy is Seven of Pentacles. Your hopes and fears is Three of Cups. And your outcome is Six of Wands. And your bottom of the deck is Ace of Cups. Beautiful. So in past, you had to go through a separation. I can see that this card has come up again, and this situation has given you a lot of clarity. Lot of clarity. Now you can decide and discern for yourself what is good for you, what is bad for you. No, nothing is confusing you anymore. You are done with confusion. You are very clear in your head that things have ended the way they have ended, and it's for my benefit. And from here, I have an idea. I can express myself in so many ways. This is infinity symbol here. Infinite possibilities are there for you, and you are thinking about all those possibilities. How can I use this situation for my benefit? Your root energy is stability, Four of Wands. So some of you are probably shifting to a new place, or you are moving into a new commitment. So you might be starting something new with like a new commitment in some sense. This is a card of stability. So even if you're not stable right now, you feel you have to work on your stability. So this is a root chakra card, but I feel you need to also focus on your throat chakra and sacral chakra. So heal those chakras, because that's the message that I'm getting. And root chakra is about facing your insecurities. So you might listen to chakra healing meditation videos on YouTube. They are quite helpful, especially before you go to sleep. Try to listen to them. What's crossing you or helping or challenging you is the Fool card. So Fool card as a challenge is that you do not want to start in something new, because you're like, this is new to me. I cannot do this all by myself. I need help and support, and you feel that this is new territory for me. I cannot do it. You feel all those fears and having self-doubt, but this card talks about you need to have inner faith and faith in the universe as well, that once you will jump from this branch as a newborn chick, you will, as you have taken that leap of faith, you will learn how to fly along the way. So have that faith, and this is a new day, a new beginning. Like I said, you are coming up as someone who is studying for something new. You are adding something to your skill or knowledge bank. You are also working towards your finances. I'm also getting that some of you will save some money. in order to put your some ideas into action. Now, one more thing. I'm getting that in future you are pretty happy with a new family. You're starting a new family, or you have a family which is very fulfilled, because some legal case you have already won, or some karmic situation is over for you. So now you are happy with your family and you are very content. This card is about prosperity and happiness and abundance. How you come up in this reading is as Son of Swords. So you might have to watch how you speak to people in your home, because you can be a little bit harsh with your words. You can be dealing with the Aries, Libra, any earth or air sign. I'm getting that you have some information and some idea that you want to communicate with your family or friends or significant other, but you have to be mindful how you communicate that thing. Now, right now things might be going slow, but you have worked on your finances, you have worked on something, and you are thinking about how much more time is it gonna take for me to get the results, basically. And you are thinking about the timing and the patience that it is going to require from you. So be patient, or someone around you is keeping their patience with you. That's also the one of the messages that I'm getting. However, some of you are thinking that someone here has a three party, and that's why probably this justice card is here, that you are finally separating from a person. Or this card can mean that you are starting something new with your life and new stability, everything new. That you are finally sharing it about it with your friends and enjoying and having a great time. You, by the end of this month of November, you are very liberated, you are being recognized. So if you keep your patience, I'm getting that you will be recognized and people will start to appreciate you, and you will in fact feel that you have come a long way. And you are liberated here, basically. And most of these things will come if you have some clarity in your mind and in your plan and in your execution strategy. Once you are clear and you have shed everything that is not serving you, any and everything that is not serving you, and you are totally focused on something new or building something new, or be patient with what you have already started or halfway through you are trying to wait for the results. If you keep your patience, you will be getting the results soon. You also have the Ace of Cups as the overall energy. So I'm getting that there is going to be emotional support available to you. Even spirits are going to be supportive of your endeavors, friends will be supportive, and there can be someone new coming in your life after a very horrible experience that you already have probably faced in the past. But once you cut yourself totally out from that situation mentally, especially if you stop thinking about this, then this can happen. Then you will be able to recognize who this person is, and then you can have this Ten of Cups with this person and start a new family with this new person and some stability. This feels like something new to me, like starting something new, something fresh, or having a fresh mindset. Maybe you will want to give someone a fresh chance. Mostly what I'm getting is that whatever you were dealing in the past, it's over and done. Unless you decide that no, you want to go back to this. So clarity of thoughts and clarity of thought is required basically. Don't get sidelined and think for what is best for you in the situation. Now let's see, what is the blockage for Pisces? You are getting soulmate, so you will be blocking a soulmate energy if you are sticking with the past is what I'm getting, because that's the message that I was getting before as well. You might lose someone who is potentially yours. I'm not saying this person is going to come in November. I'm just saying that if you keep getting stuck over someone who is in the past and you're not able to let that person go, you might not see a new person who is probably your soulmate coming your way. Bittersweet. So maybe letting go of this situation is going to be a little bit tough, but because you know that it is for your benefit, you will do it, and you are finding it a little bit hard to do it, but you will do it. And then you have creation, which is you are starting something fresh, something new, like a new business idea, or definitely something that is your brainchild basically. And let's see what is one keyword for Pisces for month of November. Confidence. Self-confidence opens you to the energy required to carry you through each day at your very best. And meditation. Confidence and meditation for the month of November are your keywords. What is Pisces card for November? This is Sacred Rebel deck. I feel this is a very Piscean card. Look at all the fishes here, and how Piscean people are very spiritual in nature. The card says in the world, not of the world. So I hope you're getting the message here. In the world, not of the world. Very, very Piscean. So that was your reading, Pisces. I hope it resonated with you and that you will make some changes in your life. And the bottom of the deck here is releasing allegiances. So release that all that is not required, and treat yourself really, really well, Pisces, in the month of November. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.